What up? This is Christina Chris, and I'm hanging out with Rob. I'm Front Row Live.
What's it like coming back to LA to perform every time?
It's amazing. And this time is especially extra, extra exciting because I've been coming out here just constantly to write all this music with detail. And so now I get to perform it for the first time ever. Right. So I'm really, really excited.
So coming to LA to record specifically with detail, why did you choose to record with detail? What is it about detail that made you want to take that trip out here?
Well, it's actually kind of like a mutual thing. I sang on a song in Detroit and it was sent to him and he heard it and he wanted to work with me. And of course I wanted to work with him. He's one of the most amazingly talented people I've ever met in my life. Mm-hmm. And I came out to do one song with him and one turned into like 15. Oh. So we just hit it off. It was amazing energy and it just kind of like happened naturally. So it was awesome. And yeah, he's a genius.
So going into the studio with detail, how did he really break you down as an artist and how did he make you find the sound that you really wanted for your music? And, you know, lyrically, how did he help you there?
It was all about like the vibe, you know, there was no pressure. We'd get in, just kick it, kind of just let like the universe guide us, you know. It was real chill and it just sparks flew. So it was like just relaxed and real.
Now with everything that you produced with, or you recorded with him, you recently dropped a new single, From the Way. Can you tell him a little bit about that single? It also features rapper Trick Trick.
Yes, that's the first single. And when we wrote that, you know, it was just about being really raw, authentic, and real. I'm from Detroit, born and raised. And everything that I talk about in that song is real everyday life in Detroit. You know, you can't ever turn on the news without hearing about another like dead body every single day. You turn on the news, it's like, you know, we see that. So it's real. We live it. All this stuff in the song is like things that I've experienced growing up there. And then when I came back from LA to Detroit with the song, I was like, I couldn't think of anyone better to be on it than Trick Trick. Okay. You know, so I sent it to him and he's like, hell yeah, I want to mess with this, you know, and then just laid one of the most amazing verses I think I've ever heard from him. It's just like, it's so authentic.
What's it like recording, like, for example, something from Detroit, but you recorded out in LA? Does the fact that you're in LA change the vibe a little bit?
No, because you can take the bitch out of Detroit, but you can't take the Detroit out of the bitch, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just that everywhere I go, but Detail's from Detroit. So it was, you know, we had that vibe. I'm born and raised there. I've always like come out to LA to work, but I just, you know, I get it like a more work vibe out here than Detroit. You get a lot more done. It's a quicker pace environment, but still the same CC.
And jumping back to working with detail, what exactly are you working on? Are we expecting a mixtape, an EP, an album?
I don't know. Right now we're just dropping singles. Okay. We got a lot of songs and they're all smashes. They're all bangers. So for now, I think we're just going to like put one by one out. There's some big features. The next single actually features French Montana.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I'm really excited about that. But that's the plan for now.
So how do these connections really happen as far as features go?
Just working and just being in the studio. Detail, you know, has made a lot of made all the magic happen. Right. So meeting people, met French in the studio and he wanted to hop on the track and it's just amazing. And then just with Trick, and then actually have another song that actually features Detail on it. So it's just kind of like flowing and just letting it happen.
So when working with French and Trick Trick, how different are they as artists?
Well, you know, I've known Trick for a long time, and he's an OG. I mean, he's been around. He's the godfather of Detroit. I mean, so much respect and blessings that I'm able to work with him, you know. And French is very talented, too, but he's newer to the game, obviously, than Trick Trick. I mean, Trick Trick is an OG, so it's different. But you know, mad respect to both of them. I'm just really excited I can work with all these different artists.
Today you're performing here at the Viper Room, like we mentioned. I believe your band is also here, right?
Yes.
So are you doing two shows every night during this tour?
No, we've been kind of mixing it up.
Okay.
And that's what's one of my favorite things about myself, if I do say so, is that coming from Detroit, I really grew up listening to everything, every genre. Mm-hmm. You know, Detroit is just so history rich with hip hop and rock. And so coming up, I listened to both of those. And forever, everyone's like, you know, you need to pick a lane. You need to pick a lane. And I'm, fuck that. You know, I'm going to do both. And I've got my band and I've got this hip hop that I've, you know, been in love with forever. And then the pop. So just blending that all together and making it work. Because it's still CeCe, you know, it's still, I'm doing it. It's just pulling all of my favorite things about music together.
Right. And it has been working, whether it was the pop or the rock or the hip hop. So what do you think it is that has made it work throughout this time?
Just the passion that I have for my music, you know, just the love that I have and the drive, you know. I love all different types of music, so I'm just going to do all of them into one and make my own lane.
Right. And when working on new material, how do you really focus on, okay, today I'm working for the band, today I'm working for myself? Like, how does that really work for you?
It's just, it's the same. I'm always just working, you know? So I don't consciously decide that I'm going to do each thing differently. I kind of just, whatever I feel that day, I do.
Okay, and then for those that haven't seen you live, why should they come out and check you guys out, whether it's the band or yourself?
Because it's the most hype, exciting live show, most interactive, you know. I feel connected to my audience, and I feel like they're connected to me. It's kind of like just this pull that happens, this flow, and it's really special, you know.
And one last thing, when you're in the studio, what's one thing that either your fans or any other artists like might not expect that goes on in the studio with you? Maybe something you struggle with.
Staying awake sometimes, because you know, out here we'd be working at not even getting in there until like midnight sometimes, you know.
And so right after the show, you're gonna go record.
Yeah, I'll be hopping off a plane from Detroit, you know, like fuck a jet lag, like I gotta just go. And so it's like I'm just drinking so much Red Bull and just like, but that's it, you know. It's just like always just stay super positive, and I'm excited to be doing it all the time. So just staying awake, that's my biggest challenge.